Hi guys, I wanted to talk to you today about my struggles with caffeine. I was always kind of sensitive to caffeine. Just recently, I became really sensitive to the point that I thought I was having a panic attack. I would get this feeling around my throat, like someone was strangling me. Just like a lot of pressure and it hurt. Take a deep breath. I felt like I couldn't take like a really deep breath. I didn't think it was anything that serious, but then I started talking to some people and they were like, you know, what if it's like your heart? What if there's like some kind of a problem? What if it's your thyroid? Like all these crazy things. I'm sorry, I just saw the mailman and I've been waiting for him, so I'm really excited he's here. So yeah, I just, you know, all these crazy things ran through my head and I just really wasn't sure what the problem was. I was taking a like metabolism booster that had some caffeine in it, so I stopped taking that, and then I also would drink like a cup of green tea every day. And you know, on the weekends I'd have a cup of coffee. It wasn't a lot, but I guess it was enough to start bothering me. I also started drinking espresso a little more, so I mean, but it still was not a lot. I would have like one espresso. Crazy! I wasn't like that. Like poor and holy. And I stopped drinking caffeine, and then I would have a little bit, and I'd get that feeling back. Stop for like another week, would have a little bit, I still was bothering me. Black tea has the most, coffee, green tea, white tea, at like, it goes from, the black tea is the most, and then green tea's not as much, and white tea's even less. And then of course there's herbal teas, which have nothing. And so I started drinking this Tazo Passion Tea. It's an herbal infusion of hibiscus, cinnamon, and tropical fruits, caffeine free. So it doesn't even have a little bit of caffeine in it. It has zero caffeine. I have now been, I think it's been 3 weeks without any caffeine. And I have to say, not only did I survive, I got past the headache from not having caffeine and I got past feeling sleepy. What I realized is that when I was drinking caffeine or ingesting like caffeine, I would do it because like I would need a boost. I feel like, okay, I woke up in the morning, I did what I had to do, and then by like afternoon I started to drag, so I'd have a cup of green tea, or I would take my metabolism pill, or whatever. And I wasn't taking a lot of the metabolism pill. I just want to say that the daily dosage that was suggested, and it's a really great company, and I don't want to say anything negative about them, because it was definitely me and my sensitivity, it's not them, was to take 2 pills in the morning and 2 pills in the afternoon, and I was taking one all day. Just one, and it still was bothering me. So it was definitely me. And I would still feel it when I had other forms of caffeine, whether it was, like I said, green tea or coffee. So just to clarify that. But I've been three weeks without caffeine, and I have to say that I don't have that tiredness in the afternoon anymore. If I get a little sleepy, I'll be like, oh, well, maybe I have to eat. Maybe my body needs to refuel, but I don't feel super tired. And now I just drink stuff like this for fun. So I've been really great right now with not having any caffeine. I talked to a friend of mine who said that she had this happen to her a while ago, and then she was able to go back to caffeine, no problem. I don't know if I will. I guess I'll just see what happens. Maybe I'll chance it or try it. But every time I want to have a little caffeine, it doesn't bother me the day I have it. It's like the next day I wake up and I'm suffering. So unless I have a couple days that I have nothing to do, that I can just like lay around and not feel like, not be that worried that I feel like crap, I kind of don't want to have it anymore, because I just have that feeling like I don't want to put myself through that. That's my story about caffeine. If any of you have had struggles with caffeine or intolerances or know anything about this, I'd love to hear your stories, your comments. Please follow me on Instagram and Twitter and Facebook. And leave comments below and just let me know what your experiences are. Really, I'm curious about this, because I was so excited when my girlfriend told me she had this problem, but nobody else that I talked to had any idea what this could be. And so if anybody else has had this experience, I want to connect with you, because I feel like now we're like sisters, unless you're a guy, and then we're like siblings. All right. Thanks for watching.